Hi everyone, welcome to the walkthrough video for the Digital Graduation Party invitation. If you have not purchased this template, I will leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. After you purchase this template, you will receive a PDF that looks just like this. Click on this button that says Digital Graduation Party invitation. If you have a Canva account and are signed into your Canva account, you will see a screen that looks just like this. However, because this is my template, I have two options here, but you will have one option that says use template for a new design. Click on that option. This is what it should look like when it opens up into your Canva account. Rename it to whatever you want to call this template. The first thing I want to do is to show you the different parts of the template. I will click on grid view so we can see all the pages included in this template. The first two pages are the invitation pages, and the last is a bonus page that you can use as a thank you video or image that you can send to your guest. This template can be used as a video or an image invitation. I'll show you how to do both. Before we start editing this template, let's preview it so we can see what it looks like as a finished product. To do this, go all the way up here next to the share icon, click on display button. That's what the template looks like. It's about 20 seconds long. If you are only going to use the first page, it would last 10 seconds. If you're going to use the first and the second page, it would be 15 seconds. And of course, you don't need to include a third page because this would be used later on after the party's over to send your guests to tell them thank you for coming to the party. So the invitation will only be about 10 or 15 seconds long. All right, so let's get started with editing this template. So if you're going to use this for a graduation, you don't need to change anything here. So just leave it as is. The next section here that we can change is this frame. Now this frame has a video, as you can see, but if you don't want to use a video here, you can change it to a still image. There are two ways that we can add an image or a video to this frame. The first way would be to upload our own video. To do this, click on the upload icon right here, and then click on upload file, navigate to the section in your computer or your phone that contains your video or your images. All right, so now that we have the images uploaded, the next thing you want to do is to drag it into the template. To do this, hover around the image. So we're going to use this image right here. Now we're going to just click and drag it into that space. As you can see, part of the image is cut off and we do want to adjust it so it fits perfectly into the circle. Double click and then pull it down. And if you wanted to maybe make it bigger, double click again. And now we're going to just pull on one of the edges until the size looks exactly what we want it to look like. And then we can adjust it either upwards, left or right until it fits perfectly. Click on done. So I'm going to pull a video from the Canva library. I also use this opportunity to show you how to use images from the Canva library. To do this, click on elements, and then we're going to search for graduation. And now we have the option of selecting photo or video. So now let's say we want to use a video. So we're going to click on that. If you have a Canva free account, stay away from the images or the videos that have this pro crown icon, because if you use any of those images, you would have to pay for it. So look for an image that doesn't have a crown to include in your invitation. So as you can see, these two images are free to use. Click, drag it into that space. And as you can see, the video shows up in this space. Repeat the same process to adjust the image. Click on done, and then we can play to preview. If you decide to use a video here, the other thing you want to do is to adjust the video duration. So like I said before, this first page would last about 10 seconds. If you add a video here, it will change the duration of the entire invitation. So we want to make sure that the video duration here coincides with the duration here. So to do this, click on the video and this menu opens up. Here we have the option to trim the video. Click on the scissors icon. And now we're going to try to match it with the video duration we want. Change to 10 seconds. Click on 10 and enter. And as you can see, it selects the first 10 seconds of the video. But let's say we wanted a different section of the video. Click and drag it to the area that we want to show. And click on done. Next thing I want to do is to change some of the text. Now you can change every single text in this template, but if you are going to be using it for a graduation, scroll all the way down and change the text right here. I changed the name to the name we want displayed here. All I did here was to select the name that was there before and I typed over it. But let's assume that the name that you want to place right here is a little bit longer, so it doesn't quite fit. So let me make the name a little bit longer so I can show you how to fix it. All right, so assuming this is what it looks like, as you can see, this doesn't look right because the name is a little bit longer than the space. Double click on the name and then go all the way up here. And as you can see, the font size 83, we can increase or decrease the font size. So in this case, we want to decrease the font size. Click on the minus, and we're going to gradually decrease it until it looks like this. So it fits perfectly with the alignment of the rest of the text. The next thing we would want to change would be to change the dates. And of course, to do this, double click whatever dates you want to type and change the time to whatever you want. And of course, change the address to whatever you want. Perfect. This is ready to go as its own invitation. But if you wanted to provide a little bit more information to your guests, use this area. Edit the information like we did before by double clicking, selecting the text and typing over it. Change the date and time, the location. And of course, right here, you have the option to add more RSVP information. So you can add a number or you can add a web page that can be used to RSVP. And the last page is a thank you page, which of course you would send to your guests after the event has been completed. Here we have a video that of course you can delete and we can add our own video. So let's say you wanted to add a video from the event because the party has been completed. Go ahead and upload it like we did before. And now we're just going to select video and drag the video into that space. And then we can edit the text here. So you can add a very short message thanking your guests for coming to your party. Another way to make it fit would be to use some of the additional space that has been provided. Click on the text, move it a little bit up, click on the line, move it a little bit higher, click on the text, drag it up. Now you have a little bit more space to add more information. Finally, select the text right here to change it to your name. The last part of this template would be to change the audio. So if you don't want to use an audio with this video invitation, you don't have to. Let me show you how to remove the audio or how to use a different audio. All right, to do this, we're going to click on this arrow that says show pages. Click on that. And right here is the audio. So double click to open it up. And now click on the audio, and when you go up here, you see we have audio effects and we have adjust. Click on this icon right here next to adjust, and right here is where you can mute the audio. So if you mute the audio and you play, as you can see, there is no audio. So go ahead and close it, or you can just delete the audio completely. You can upload your own audio. When you upload your files, it will be organized into images, videos, and audio. If you upload your own audio, it would show up right here. Or you can decide to use an audio from the Canva library. To find an audio, navigate to audio. And as you can see, we have different sounds here. If you have a Canva Pro account, of course, there will be no problem with using this audio. But if you don't, you have to find a free audio file to use. I have graduation already typed here, which is why all of the songs here are showing up as graduation songs. I changed it to party to see if we can get a little bit more upbeat music. All right, so we're going to select this option here, drag the audio right here and drop it. And you can see the audio fits right into the space. If you wanted to use the audio just for this section, you can do so by clicking and dragging until it stops at 15 seconds, which is the duration of these two files. Adjust the volume. And now we're going to preview to see what it looks like. The last step would be to download this file. To do this, click on share and click on download. It already defaults to MP4 video, which is fine. But if this option does not show up for you, just click on the arrow and navigate to MP4 video. And then click on all pages right here, click on the arrow. If you only intend on using the first page, unselect page 2 and page 3. So we only have page 1 selected. Click on done and click on download. If you wanted to download page 1 and page 2, click on page 1 and page 2 and click on download. So our file has been downloaded. I'm going to save it in my downloads file and we'll go over what it looks like. In the meantime, I want to show you how to download it as an image file. Click on PNG. And you don't have to select any of these options. We're going to select page 1 and click on done. And then we're going to download. And finally, if you really wanted to use it with the option to have clickable links, click on share, click on download, and click on PDF. Now again, if you use this option, the only advantage is that you will have links that you can add clickable links. Other than that, I don't recommend this because none of the videos, none of the animations would show up. But if you wanted to use it as a PDF, go ahead, click on PDF standard and click on download. All right, now let's preview the files that we have downloaded. Here is what it looks like. As you can see, it's only 10 seconds long because we only downloaded the first page. Let's play it and see what it looks like. Here is what the image file looks like. It looks exactly like the video file. The only difference is that there are no animations. There is no sound. Now that you have these two files, save it to your devices and email it or text it to your guests. The last thing I wanted to show you, because I did forget to point it out, is how to change the color, because everything can be edited, including the color. Let's say we wanted to change this color from the yellow to something else. Click on the text and right here, click on text color. And let's say we wanted to use pink instead. We wanted to change everywhere that had yellow text before we wanted to have pink text. Click on change all. And this is what it looks like with the pink text. Finally, if you wanted to send this to your guest as a link instead of sending them a file, click on share and click on create public link view. If you create this link, anyone that has the link can view the video. They don't have to have a Canva account. All they'll need to do is have connection to the internet to be able to view this file. So that's another way that you can decide to send your invitation to your guests by sending them a link. So create public link view. And now we're going to copy this and paste it into our browser to see what it looks like. Here is what it looks like in our browser. This can be viewed on a browser, on a computer, on a laptop, on a phone, or a tablet. That brings me to the end of this tutorial. If you have any questions, then send me a message. If you purchase this on Etsy, send me a message there. I'll also leave my email address so you can send me an email. And of course, you're welcome to leave your questions in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching.